Look, I'll be the first to tell you that I'm not an expert when it comes to putting music in YouTube videos, but I put a lot of music in YouTube videos.
Okay, now listen, some of the video that you're about to watch may not be for everybody. It's definitely a different kind of video than I normally make. We normally make videos where we're out here doing the hiking thing, but one of my favorite parts about making YouTube videos is adding music. I love adding music to YouTube videos, and that's what we're talking about in this video, is adding music, what that does to a video, and can it be overdone? Probably, yes. It probably can be overdone. I know that I overdo adding music to videos. I really do, but I love it and I don't care. It's just what I enjoy doing.
Not because I do it right, but because I really enjoy it. When I started making YouTube videos, I wasn't concerned with making a fortune on YouTube. Sure, it matters and it's a little bit of validation for the artistic work that you're doing, but also I'm pretty tacky when it comes to putting music in YouTube videos. Getting the mix right is hard enough. But I'm that guy that when I'm watching other YouTube channels, I'm listening for the music that they have in the background. And I've used so much YouTube music, you know, the canned music that YouTube creators can put in their videos without having to pay any type of royalties or anything. I've used so much of it that I can just about name the songs now, the little tunes, the little jingles when I'm watching my favorite YouTubers. I can say, oh, that's from this and that's from this. And it's really cool because YouTube offers a lot of music that you can put in videos. I think the most irritating videos that I watch are ones that don't have any music in them. Even if I realize my videos are pretty tacky when it comes to how much music there is, I've even been inspired to make videos before based strictly on the music. I'll hear something from the canned music and I'll think, I need to make a video about this. I think it helps the creative energy. That's just me. But in this video, what I want to talk about, the different music that's on YouTube, what the name of the songs are, and things like that. I hope you enjoy it.
It's a lot of fun for YouTube creators like myself to shoot images and then change the meaning or reinterpret the meaning with music. It's just a lot of fun. But I think a lot of it's because the tools to do that, it's available to everybody now. So everybody's taking images and creating new meaning out of video images.
Wow.
It's definitely a stretch to blame the music in a video that does, you know, I agree, it invokes emotion, but I think it's a stretch to blame the music as something that helps convince people. I think it helps create the atmosphere and the mood, but people believe what they want to believe regardless of the music that's in the background. The music in the background just makes it better and more entertaining, which is how I feel about most conspiracy videos. If they're done right, they're entertaining, but that doesn't mean you believe what they say. That blames YouTube conspiracy theories for people believing in conspiracies. I believe people have always believed in conspiracy theories. I mean, I've just grown up around people, both conservatives and liberals, who have their conspiracy theories. But what YouTube and Facebook and other social media sites have provided is a forum, a place for these a community of believers to get together and discuss their beliefs and thumbs up and share. I don't think people typically care when it comes to music inside of YouTube videos, but I will say this, I think that people's attention span is a lot different now than it was a few years ago when it comes to YouTube videos. For instance, a lot of people loved unique and glorious intros and outros and all that kind of stuff, and I think that's kind of gone to the wayside because our attention span is a lot different, so people want you to get to the point quicker, which is really difficult for creative people like me who really enjoy making fun intros and outros and things like that.
We said none of what we did, and we're still not afraid. Because I can promise you this. If I didn't pay the price for the things we both know I did do, I'm certainly not going to pay the price for the things I didn't do. Well, of course, they're going to say I'm being disrespectful, not playing by the rules, like I ever played by anyone's rules before. I never did. And you loved it. Anyhow, despite all the poppycock, the animosity, the headlines, the impeachment without a trial, despite everything, despite even my own death, I feel surprisingly good. And my confidence grows each day that soon enough, you will know the full truth. But wait a minute. Now that I think of it, you never actually saw me die, did you? Conclusions can be so deceiving. Miss me?
I do the little da. Thank you.
creating new meaning out of video images. And it's a lot of fun, but and I think for a lot of people it is misleading, but I don't think that it's a huge, huge problem. Because you can mislead people without music. You can mislead people with words. Even when people do news editorial on YouTube, Philip DeFranco being somebody that I watch on occasion, he doesn't use any type of music or anything like that, but you can still, not saying that Phil does this, but you can still manipulate people with words or the way that you tell a story or the type of images that you use without using music. So I don't think music alone is the main problem in videos.